Medea, I had a vision of a sword knight in black armor. He was meeting in hell with the demons. The knight was empowered with the powers of darkness. His mission is to bring the greatest number of souls to hell and make life difficult for those who resist his authority, the Holy Spirit said. This warrior you see will declare war on the saints and will be the greatest spiritual warfare of all time. The sword that is in his hand means the word of the lie that will cause the spiritual death of his worshippers, and for those who do not prefer to follow Jesus, will cause physical death. In the vision, I saw when this knight was behind a spiritual wall and passed by entering our world, and when that happened he was no longer a knight, but a man. I could not see the face of this man for God's sake, but I saw his body from the neck down, an elegant and good-looking man, very different from Jesus when he became incarnate on earth and was born in a manger, the son of humble parents. This man is extremely intelligent and rich with a speech that could persuade the world population. Today the church is at war against what is spiritual, but the day will come that evil will cease to be spiritual and will reveal itself in person, and the eyes of the whole world will see him. The personification of evil will wreak the greatest spiritual battle ever against the church, and it will be a bloody battle. The Lord showed me in a vision devils enthroned in the minds and hearts of the governors. Their hearts were dominated to put laws of persecution to the Christians. Their evil minds were controlled to surrender the world into the hands of the future Antichrist. I also saw the multiplication of sin and demons reigning over the life of every person who was not converted. Many did not want to give up sin and pluck sin out of their life by force. The kingdom of Satan was upon the lives of many brethren through sin. Church, give no place to this kingdom. Take it out of control of your lives. Free yourself from the evil system of this world, dethrone the demons that work in your life, free yourself from the influence of the world, put Jesus as King on the throne of your life, let Jesus rule your life, take control and let the Holy Spirit reign in your center, turn away from sin, temptations, and pleasures. The Lord showed me an army of demons for the future government of Satan on earth. He took the mental control of the people with his mark. 666. The governors received the future emperor of the New World Order. I saw the demons planning to form the government of the Antichrist, using all the most important politicians on earth. I want to tell all believers not to run for office. There is no dispute between parties. They are all friends and are planning the reign of the Antichrist. They just pretend they are enemies within the media to deceive voters and lie with false promises. One day Satan possessed a woman and said to me, at that moment the greatest sorcerers are releasing demons to enter into the maternal wombs. These babies are special children. They will still be possessed in the womb. They will be born with great emotional and intellectual abilities. They will be the future politicians, doctors, and judges, who will prepare the new world order for the Antichrist. You will be one of those men who will perform the opening ritual for a new era. I need you to make your sorcerer level grow until you become one of the great ones. All these pastors I spoke to are New Age followers with me. The goal of the New Age is to unite all religions to receive the Antichrist. Pastors who are involved in the New Age cannot preach against sects. They have to join them to form a new religion. Buddhist concepts and philosophies are being integrated into the gospel. Spiritualist concepts and Hindu movements are entering the church. Taoism, Confucianism, Satanism and spiritualism and others are mingling with Christian teachings. There is a fusion of these teachings to form a unique theology. When you create a teaching that is mixed with all religious concepts, you create a single religion and one God. The Antichrist, they are mixing the pure with the profane, blending diversified teachings into one. With the result of this mixture are born several evangelical currents. Look at the movements that emerged, the Neo-Pentecostals, the Liberation Movements, and the Unicists. The altars of the churches are desecrated with miraculous objects and the ministers desecrate the pulpits with their sinful lives. Today's Christian church has stopped preaching against sin. That is the plan of the New Age, to bring Catholics and Christians together. This is the Antichrist's ecumenical project of uniting religions and peoples. As a participant of the New Age, I no longer believed in the churches. I went down to hell with the angel. He told me, today we are going to visit a part of hell, the abyss. The angel and I entered hell and then we went into a different place. In that place, there were no souls and no demons tormenting souls. It was a dark place without fire and a legion of angels trapped in that place. They were not demons but angels who have sinned in the past and were in an abyss. I came near an angel. He looked at me with great hatred and tried to grab me, but the chains held that angel, preventing him from catching me. I looked at these angels. They were black and their original forms of angels disappeared and gave place to monsters of horrifying aspects. I suddenly saw them become locusts. Their appearances were as described in Revelation 9-7-8, and the shapes of the locusts were like unto horses prepared under battle, and on their heads were as it were crowns like gold, and their faces were as the faces of men, and they had hair as the hair of women, and their teeth were as the teeth of lions. I had never witnessed devils so terrible. The angel said, "These are the grasshopper angels who will be loosed to torment the earth. Satan will receive the key of that place and will lead this army and release these creatures to harm humanity." I said, "There the earth will be like a living hell when these creatures go up there." The angel showed me an angel who was trapped in the chains. This angel turned into a dragon with several heads. The angel said, "That is the beast who will be the Antichrist on earth." The angel showed me a part of the abyss where there was no angel trapped, a vast, dark and dangerous place, prepared for someone. The angel said, "This place is where Satan will be trapped for 1,000 years, Satanic Church's Antichrist." The angel of the Lord took me to another church. I do not know if this church was inside or outside my country. I just know that when I entered that church I felt a strange sensation. It was not like the others I had entered. When I stepped there in that place I saw several demons, but they were not walking inside the church. They were incorporated in each member that was there. The angel of the Lord allowed me to see devils attached to them inside their bodies. I looked at the shepherd who was on top of that pulpit. I saw his face transfigured in the face of a terrible demon. I said to the angel, "No, no, this cannot be happening. I ministered in several churches and never saw it. What does that mean? Is this a church?" The angel said, "These are satanic infiltrators, Satanists, and sorcerers who open churches and pass themselves up as shepherds. They are agents of the demons." And I asked, "These people cannot see anything?" The angel said, "These blind people obey their doctrines without questioning. Look at their faces." When I looked at them, I saw they had no eyes. There were holes in place of their eyes. The angel said, "The spirit of Antichrist of those who are against the precepts of Christ already reign on earth. The purpose of these agents of Satan is to corrupt the other churches with their doctrines. They have goals. They have great knowledge of the word, have great theology and positions. All this benefits them to be called to go preach in any church through their status." The angel said, "If there was a person in this church with eyes open, the Holy Spirit would be in that place. He would use that person to open the eyes of others. When you stepped on that spot, you perceived a strange sensation. That is the absence of the Holy Spirit in that place." I asked the angel, "As Satan is bold, he is already placing his soldiers within our ministries." The angel said, "Warn the churches not to get carried away by the fame and status of preachers and their diplomas of positions. Warn the church to watch. Do not open the doors for strangers to minister. It is better to give the opportunity to the little ones of the same church that the pastor already knows than to give the opportunity to an unknown preacher." The angel said, "Look at these people's hands." I looked and saw their hands were chained. The angel said, "These people live in blind obedience, but if they know the truth they will come out of the deceit and receive the deliverance of these demons that are in their bodies. Tell the church to ask for the gift of discernment and of the vision."